Megaworld Corporation names its COO as its new president. Lourdes Gutierrez Alfonso was elected to the post at a special meeting of the company's directors today. She steps into the role of Mr. Andrew Tan, who will remain as chairman of the board of directors. Gutierrez Alfonso has been with Megaworld since the 90s. She's currently a director in the real estate firm's affiliated companies, including Global Estate Resorts and Emirate. Her election also comes amid the leadership shakeup in the Andrew Tan Group that saw the exit of Alliance Global's top boss, King Son Sian. Next to SM Prime, which listed on Monday its 25 billion peso fixed retail bonds at the PDEX. Series V, W, and X are due in 2027, 2029, and 2031, respectively. This is the first tranche of SM Prime's fixed-rate bonds shelf registration worth 100 billion pesos. And finally, Greenergy Holdings is injecting half a billion pesos to its unit, Winsen Green Ventures. It's subscribing to 480 million shares of Winsen at 1 peso per share with an initial payment of 185 million pesos. Greenergy says the move will seek to strengthen Winsen's position in the local renewable energy space. Agricultural groups insist government bypass proper procedures in reducing the tariff for imported rice. They are set to file a petition to declare Executive Order 62 illegal. The EO reduces the tariff on imported rice from 35% to 15% through 2028, presumably to lower rice prices.
The Tariff Commission should have conducted an investigation. An investigation specifically para dito sa issuance ng Executive Order 62. Kasi ang sinasabi nila, nag-investigate daw sila noon. Pero investigation na kinundak nila yon, that was the same investigation used for the previous executive orders.
Agri groups insist the reduction in tariffs of the staple grain will only do more harm than good.
The assumption is that the lower the tariffs, the lower the retail price. Partly correct, but mostly wrong. When you bring down the tariff rates, it's true the cost to the importer goes down, but the importer then gets the profit and sells at market. So in the rice tariffication, for example, you'll find that they brought down the tariff so low, 35%. We did not have safeguards. The retail price went down by only 2%, but the farmers lost 28%. So you see, in this rice issue, we want to have more views, and therefore we want the hearings.
Fitch Solutions Unit BMI sees the Philippines' tourist arrivals posting double-digit growth for the next 4 years. BMI expects tourist arrival numbers to grow 32% year-on-year to reach 6.6 million in 2024. That figure is already 81% of the 8.2 million tourist arrivals recorded in 2019 before the COVID-19 pandemic took its toll on the global tourism industry. BMI also believes the country's growth rates will push tourist arrivals to 8.3 million next year and further swell to 9.4 million in 2028.